Jackie Keith Whitley was born July 1, 1955, in Kentucky. Whitley learned to play guitar by the time he was 8 years old. Although he loved singing the tunes of country greats Lefty Frizzell, Hank Williams, and George Jones, his first musical group was a bluegrass band he formed at 13.
When I was 12, 13 years old, I really had a strong desire to be a member of a band. And there were no country musicians at that time, but there were a lot of really good bluegrass bands. And I became quite a bluegrass fan. We did, I think, probably, I would say 90% Stanley Brother material at that time.
As a teenager, Whitley befriended and began performing with future country superstar Ricky Skaggs. The two youngsters soon joined Ralph Stanley's Clinch Mountain Boys.
We just hit it off from the very start, and so within a month from that time, Ricky was working in the band with, and then that led to our meeting Ralph Stanley, and we became members of Ralph's band.
Whitley performed with the band on and off until 1978, when he joined the country bluegrass group J.D. Crow and the New South. While Whitley spent his teen years honing his musical skills, he also formed a habit that would plague him throughout his career: heavy drinking. In 1983, Whitley left Kentucky behind, moving to Nashville to seek success as a solo country artist. He signed with RCA Records and released a honky-tonk-focused EP, A Hard Act to Follow, in 1984. The highest charting single from his debut effort, Turn Me to Love, reached number 59 on the U.S. country singles charts.
Turn me around, turn me on, turn me to love.
In October of 1985, Whitley released his first full-length solo album, L.A. to Miami. The album would catapult Whitley to country fame with 5 high-charting singles, including the number 14, Miami, My Amy, and the top 10 hits, 10 Feet Away, Homecoming 63, and Hard Livin'.
Homecoming 63.
While touring to promote the album, Whitley met country music singer Lori Morgan, the daughter of the late Grand Ole Opry star George Morgan. They married the following year and would go on to have one child, Jesse Keith Whitley, who was born in 1987.
We wanted a child from the very start, and we wanted a boy really bad. Both of us wanted a boy, and God must have heard us talking because he sent him to us pretty much like we wanted him.
During this period, Whitley continued to drink heavily, but more in secret. Morgan would later say that she often had to tie his leg to hers during the night to prevent his getting out of bed to drink. Regardless of his battle with alcohol, Whitley's musical career continued to skyrocket with the 1988 release of Don't Close Your Eyes. The album would feature 3 consecutive number one hits on the Hot Country Singles charts: Don't Close Your Eyes, When You Say Nothing at All, and I'm No Stranger to the Rain.
Don't close your eyes, let it be.
The album also included an homage to his idol, Lefty Frizzell, showcasing Whitley's cover of I Never Go Around Mirrors, If I Got a Heartache to Hide.
My favorite singer, and probably about 90% of the reason that I decided to get in this business, was a gentleman from the state of Texas by the name of Lefty Frizzell. Do we have any Lefty Frizzell fans here tonight?
So
would not enjoy his success for long. On May 9, 1989, Keith Whitley was found dead in his bed. He was 33 years old. The cause of death was ruled to be acute alcohol poisoning, but would become the source of conspiracy theories since many were under the impression that Whitley had begun to get his drinking under control. He was buried at Spring Hill Cemetery in Nashville, Tennessee. Whitley's lifelong friend, Ricky Skaggs, sang at the funeral, and David Frizzell, brother Lefty Frizzell, was among the pallbearers.
Tell Lori I love her. Tell Lori I need her. Tell her everything would be okay if I could just see her.
Keith Whitley's life and career were cut tragically short. But he managed to leave behind a musical legacy that lives on today and continues to influence aspiring young country singers.
And if I leave this old world, tell her she's the only girl for me.
Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like the video and to subscribe.